You want to create a plastic wrap effect, sort of thing in Photoshop, but in Infinity Photo, PC or Mac. Well, how to do that? Go to the Select menu, and then down to, I'm going to go for Tonal Range, and then go for Select Midtones. Want a selection, so I've got a nice selection here. You can see quite a lot of the image has been selected. And then what you can do, you can go and use Outline. So Select and Outline. I'm going to set it to 5 pixels. Now the document's fairly large, it's about 3,800 odd by 2,400, etc. So obviously this really depends on the size of image. So I'm just going to go for 5 though in this place. So click apply. So I've got now an outline which actually outlines all the way around all that selection. So you've got a very thin outline. But also I'm going to apply a feather. So I'm just going to go to select and feather. So feather there. Again, panels always go down to the bottom of the screen. It's always slightly annoying. And I'm going to set that to about, say, 10. You could vary it, just doesn't matter. Exactly, you could just play around with the setting that you happen to like. But I'm going with 10. So you can see now you've got this nice, sort of slightly more unusual sort of outline appearing. And click apply. Once you've done that, well, I'm going to copy and paste it. That's it, just simply go and copy and paste it. And so edit and copy, because I want it as a layer. So I'm just going to go to edit and now paste. So I'm just going to paste it back in again. So I've got this design as a, I don't want the selection anymore. So select and deselect. So you can't see any difference. Actually, there's no difference whatsoever. However, you've got this new layer, which is on top, which you can apply layer effects to. So what you can do, just go down here to the FX. There's a little FX down here. And there's a variety of different ones you can add. You could, of course, go for outer shadows, all those sort of things, which creates quite nice effects as well. But what I want for the plastic wrap effect, I'm going to go for bevel and emboss. That offers quite a range of options. So bevel and emboss, and you can see as soon as I set this value up, and I'm just going to push it up, you can see a slight change there. And you can see a sort of nice plasticky sort of effect there appearing straight away over this image. You've got all the nice there, you can just see the bevel there. But also what you can do, of course, you can change the direction. You can move it around, and you can see as you do that, you get this very, very plastic wrap type effect appearing. So something like that, you can just set it to maybe right in the middle, and you get this very plastic wrap effect. But you can set it to other areas, and that's one thing that creates other additional effects. But I think about in the middle there, you've got that nice thing. And of course, you can change all the settings. You can change the soften, vary various highlights, etc. So there's a whole load of things you can do. But there you have it. A nice plastic wrap effect in Affinity Photo. So click close. And you can see it's just simply a layer. So what you can do, well, of course, you could apply other effects, do other things to it. But you can also just go to layer and then down to merge visible. So it comes obviously part of the same thing. And you can remove the other ones there. And that's it. Nice one layer with your plastic wrap effect. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.